Welcome student, today I am going to explain chapter 4, Carbon and its compounds, part 13, chemical properties of ethene, ethyl alcohol or ethanol. In the third point of chemical properties of ethanol, we discuss esterification or reaction of alcohol with carboxylic acid. In that reaction, the reaction product that is known as an ester, when reacted with an alkali, they hydrolyze and give a soap molecule or sodium or potassium salt of carboxylic acid. So we obtain soap in this process. So such process is also known as saponification. So what is saponification? We have to know what is saponification. When the reaction mixture, that means an ester that are obtained after the reaction with an alcohol with carboxylic acid, that gives us ester. And when ester is treated with sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide, ester is treated with sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide solution, the ester is transformed back into alcohol and a salt of long chain carboxylic acid. Such hydrolysis of an ester with an alkali is called saponification. For example, ethyl ethanoate, that is an ester, when reacted with sodium hydroxide, that is an alkali, it gives ethanol, the parent alcohol that are used in the process of esterification. So that alcohol is obtained after the saponification. The ethanol is obtained and a salt of carboxylic acid is also obtained, that is known as here sodium ethanoate. So we see that saponification is a process in which an ester hydrolyzed with an alkali to give soap. So such process is known as saponification. Now we have to discuss the fourth reaction, that is reaction with sodium metal. Sodium, as we know that sodium is very reactive metal. So when ethanol reacts with sodium, it gives or produces hydrogen gas and sodium ethoxide, that is a salt. The reaction is ethanol reacts with sodium metal, gives sodium ethoxide. Sodium ethoxide, this is ethoxide and this is sodium. So this compound is known as sodium ethoxide, and hydrogen gas is evolved in this experiment. So the reaction of sodium with ethanol gives sodium ethoxide and hydrogen. That is a characteristic property of ethanol or other alcohols. Now last chemical property is the reaction with bleaching powder. When ethanol is heated with bleaching powder and water, chloroform and calcium formate are produced. In the first reaction, we see that this is bleaching powder, or it is also known as calcium oxychloride. This is bleaching powder is also known as calcium oxychloride. When reacted with water, it gives calcium hydroxide and chlorine. When ethanol react with this chlorine, it gives ethanol. And when ethanol is reacted with chlorine, it gives chloral. And hydrogen chloride, and this chloral when hydrolyzed with water, it gives chloroform and methanoic acid. And when methanoic acid is reacted with calcium hydroxide, it gives calcium formate and water. So this is the reaction of bleaching powder with ethanol. And this is the last chemical properties of ethanol. Now we have to know about some special form of ethanol. That is, first one is rectified spirit that are used in medical lines and in burners in laboratories. What are rectified spirit? Rectified spirit is an aqueous solution. Rectified spirit is an aqueous solution of ethanol. Produces a constant boiling. Produces a constant boiling mixture which contains 95% ethanol and 4.4% of water. This is called rectified spirit. Now we have to go absolute alcohol. What are absolute alcohol? When rectified spirit is heated under reflux over quicklime for about 5 to 6 hours, then allowed to stand. Then allowed to stand for 12 hours. And after that, on distillation, pure alcohol, that means 100% pure alcohol is obtained. This is called absolute alcohol. So pure alcohol is known as that have 100% ethanol, or other alcohol is known as absolute alcohol. In this rectification, we have to know reflux. What are reflux? Reflux means heating under, heating is done in a round bottom flask. Heating is done in a round bottom flask which is attached to a vertical condenser. That gives the vapors of liquid which rises up and get condensed in condenser and fall back into the flask. So for this process we use reflux in the formation of absolute alcohol. So in the next class we have to discuss about the next compound of organic compounds, that are acetic acid or ethanoic acid. Till then, goodbye.